Dear friends, welcome to my video. In this video, I'll show you how to create your own compass Android app using magnetic field and accelerometer sensors. So let's begin. As usual, I'll create a very simple layout. I'll just name it, say for example, my compass app. You can name it anything, it doesn't matter, as I have told in most of my tutorials. So we'll have to pause. So I pause the video for a few seconds for this layout to get created. So now it has created, so now we can our IDE has got loaded, so now we can start our designing. So first I'll create a simple layout over here. So in this layout we will have a very simple design. We won't need any text view or something. Probably we'll need a kind of like pointer which keeps rotating as and when required. So for that, what we can do is probably we can probably we can download or copy. So I have already copied one of the very simple pointer from Google Images, so it's already there. So we can just copy paste or save it in a file under probably drawable should be fine. So you can name the file as per your wish, but make sure that all the letters are in a small letter and no capital letters are used. So once this the image file has been created, so I can now use the image view from my palette to create my image. And here I can use this pointer. So this is the pointer which we will use to show the direction in our this compass app. You can place it as it is. And apart from this, I don't think we'll need anything else, but just for the as a backup or something, like I'll just also create a button which will like a reset button. It will, what it will do is it will reset the direction of this pointer to probably 0 or 180 degree or something like that. We can put it, yeah. So now we'll quickly put the constraints for this one and also for the image view. So that's all. There is some warning, so let's quickly resolve it. So you have to create resources for the hard-coded text. So you just do a quick fix from the hint what Android Studio gives, and that should be fine. So once our layout is created, now we can jump into the code is what I think, but in parallel I'll also start the app in the emulator so that we can see the layout, how it comes up. And I don't think that there is anything else required. So yeah, I already started and this emulator has come up, so we can just place it side by side so that we can see both. And our design looks good. Only thing is the reset button is a little below, so we can probably shift it a little up also in our layout, and that should be fine. Yeah, so I think more or less we are done. Now we can move to our main Java code. So here I can remove this palette so we get okay. I can just move to the Java code. So before I get into the logic, so let me explain what are the logic which I'll be following over here. So I'll quickly switch to this my Google. So over here we'll be using the getOrientation method basically to get the orientation. And if you see the first output of this getOrientation method, the value is 0. What it says is it gives the angle of rotation about a z axis, which is nothing but the axis perpendicular to the plane of the phone. And this value represents the angle between the device axis and the magnetic north pole, which is nothing but the north pole of our planet Earth. Of course, if there is any magnetic influence in the local vicinity due to, say, for example, magnetic fields of electric currents or some device, then it will not be accurate. But otherwise, in open, it should be accurate. So we'll use basically this get orientation method. And before I get into details, so just quickly I'll see to run this get orientation, what are the inputs I need is R and values. So R is nothing but it's the rotation matrix which we get from get rotation matrix. So get rotation matrix is nothing but it needs, so it will give R is an output, but it needs input as gravity and geomagnetics. So that's why we will need the sensors of type accelerometer and type magnetic field for this particular method. So let's begin. So before we start, we'll need certain local or private variables over here. So first is one of them is image view. The this particular the handle to this image view widget. So because we will be rotating this from our code over here, so image view, and we will also have this find view by id r dot id dot image view. Yeah, so now this image view, the variable in this code, is associated with this widget in this app or layout. Okay, so before we move, we also complete this particular on click method of this button. That button is reset button, so public void reset button. A spelling mistake, a spelling doesn't matter, but we should of course write correct English. Okay, so once done this, so the only thing I will do in it is I will rotate or set the rotation of this particular image probably to 0 degree or 180 degree. So let me set it to 180 degree. So that should be fine. And also I'll have to go into my layout and set the callback or on click method over here to reset button. So whenever now this button is pressed, this particular method will be called. So apart from this, what else we need is we need certain other variables. One is the sensor manager, which will be responsible to get the sensors handle from our phone, and probably we'll need few sensors. And as you saw in the documentation, we'll need the sensors for type accelerometer and type magnetic field. So we'll have sensor accelerometer, and also we'll have another sensor called sensor magnetic field. Yeah, so once we have it, what else we'll need? Probably the values which will derive here from this sensor, so we can have that also in as a class variable. So we will define a couple of more variables, and all this output is in the float. So we'll have float. For accelerometer, we will have gravity as an output, and we can assign it over here. It will be a matrix of array of size 3 because x, y, and z. Similarly, we'll do it for the other one. So float, and probably we can name it as geomagnetic new float 3. Yes. What else we need is probably we need the final output of orientation, which will be returned by this particular method. So we'll define one more variable called orientation. That will be my float orientation, and it will be again a matrix or an array of size 3. And finally, we will also need one variable to store the output of this rotation matrix, which is nothing but R. So this will be rotation matrix. So float rotation matrix, and this will be not of size 3, but it will size 9. So it's a 3x3 matrix. So it becomes I should have done 9 here. So it will become an array of size 9. It will have 9 elements. So I think more or less done. We don't need any more variable as of now, is what I can think of. So we can start our logic implementation. So first and foremost, we will create the sensors for our this accelerometer and the magnetic field. So first let me define the sensor manager, which will need the access to the system service called sensor service. Yes. So once done this, probably we can typecast it to sensor manager, and then what we'll need is we'll need access to the sensors. One is accelerometer, so that we can do by sensor manager dot get default sensor, and this sensor will be nothing but the sensor of type accelerometer. Yes, it was the first one. Similarly for the other one, magnetic field, we'll need the access to, I think first I should go for a sensor manager dot get default sensor and sensor dot type magnetic field. Perfect. So once we have these sensors, now we can define the listeners. For the sensors, the listeners are nothing but they will do the specific task whenever there is any change in the value, and in the end we will register our sensors for the respective listeners. So first let's define a listener for sensor event listener, and this is sensor event listener for, say for example, accelerometer. I'll first define. So this is nothing but it will give the gravity, and here we can define new sensor event listener, and automatically all the methods, required methods will be created. So it will give you two methods: on accuracy change and on sensor change. So we'll only use the on sensor change. So here the event will have the values of the accelerometer. So this is where we will use this variable which would define somewhere on top, the float gravity, to get the values. So we will have float gravity equals to nothing but event dot values. Yes, so now our gravity will have the updated values whenever there is a slight change in the values of the sensor. Similarly, we can do one thing: we can create a sensor event listener for the magnetic field, and we can name it as magnetic field equal to new. So steps will be exactly same. The only difference will be here, instead of gravity, of course we will geomagnetic, the other variable we will assign the value. Yes, perfect. So semicolon at the end. Now at the end we will have to register these sensors. So we can register them using this sensor manager dot register listener, and the first input will be, I think, the listener itself. So we have two listeners. One is for accelerometer, which will be associated with the sensor called accelerometer, of course, and the third input is the delay or the sampling. So we'll just keep it normal. We should not misuse or go for fast. Here they give even the fast update, so we should not use it because it will just unnecessarily consume more power, more battery resources of your phone. So only if needed, then only go for the fast response. Otherwise, normal delay is the perfect combination here. Now we'll register the second sensor, so which is nothing but magnetic field, and over here we'll again keep the delay as sensor manager delay. So once our so I think more or less our structure of the code is ready. So we have got we have registered all the sensors, and we have got the, whenever there is any value change, we'll get those values here. Now the only thing which we is left is we have to do this computation of this get orientation method over here. But to get first compute get orientation, we need get rotation matrix. So now we have two options: either we do all this computation in a separate method, but I will suggest that better we do it over here on sensor change over here itself, because whenever there is a slight change in the value of the sensor, I would like that to get reflected in our over here in this output. So first let's compute the get rotation matrix. So that's, for that we have to go for sensor manager dot get rotation matrix. Yes, and here we have four inputs. First is the R, which is nothing but the I think our float rotation matrix. So we can define our float rotation matrix. So this will give the output. So this particular variable is not an input, but it will get an output from this particular method whenever it returns. Then the second input was, I think, for inclination, which we can keep it null. Third is for, I think, gravity, and which is basically the output of the accelerometer. So we can use this float gravity because this gets updated the value over here. So we will just use third input over here as float gravity, and the fourth one will be the float geomagnetic. Perfect. So once we have the get rotation matrix done, so now what we can do is, we can similarly call the get orientation, And in this, the first input will be R matrix, which will be nothing but I think float rotation matrix, and the second is the values which will contain the output of this particular method. So that is for orientation. Yes, so that's all I think. Yeah, so finally float orientation is the variable which will contain the exact value of our output. So we can use this to rotate our image to that many degrees accordingly. So we can use probably image view dot set rotation, and here it should be a float input of float orientation. So float orientation we can give as, and of course we have to take the zeroth, the first element. Why? Because we should go back to our documentation here, and if you go to get orientation, this is the value zero is the angle, because all the other values, it returns three values, values one and values two are something different. It returns pitch and roll. So we are not interested in pitch and roll. We are only interested in azimuth, which is nothing but the angle between y-axis of the phone and the magnetic north pole. So this is the, what we are interested. But one point to note, the range of this is minus pi to plus pi, whereas in the in our Android, this rotation takes in degrees. So we have to change this pi to degrees. So for that, what we can do is we can multiply it by 180 degree and divide it by 3.14159. This is approximate values of pi, but I think it should be fine. So and there is some warning, so I think double to we have to do a casting, that's fine. And also please note, you should negate it, because this will work if you don't negate it will work fine if your phone is upside down. So when you the phone is facing upwards, this should be negated. So believe me, it's important, because it then only the rotation will be fine. So if I try to explain you in simple words, what will happen is in actually the value return over here will be positive, and when you move it positive, it will move this side, but actually this will be west when the phone rotates and not the east. So when you make it negative, it takes care of that east to west rotation. So you try with all both negative and positive, and probably you'll get to understand what I'm trying to speak over here. Okay, so similarly, once you're done here, I think same code will be required for the other sensor also. So whenever the value changes over here, same code will be required. So I'll just do a copy paste here, because we need rotation matrix as an output, and that will give as an input to get orientation. Float orientation is the output which we'll get from here and which we'll use over here. Okay, perfect. So I think more or less our code is done. I'll just quickly run it so that we can see it in our app. So if you see, it's turned towards this side. Probably we'll see why it is turned towards this side, but I'll also quickly try to test my reset button. So reset button is working fine. If you noticed or if you have observed, we gave reset button is 180 degree, which is nothing but this is 180 degree, and right now it's turned towards 90 degree, which is probably, of course, in emulator you can't emulate the magnetic field very nicely. So we'll also go for virtual sensors and we'll see if we can try to emulate something over here. So in the virtual or extended controls, go in the extended controls and virtual sensors. How you can open it is by clicking on these three buttons. These three buttons over here, this window will come up, and once you have this window, then try to rotate x-axis. So if you see, if I rotate the phone along x-axis, my this compass moves. Also I'll try with z-axis. Of course orientation also changes, so I think there should be a way to lock this orientation, but I'll not invest time. Okay, so this changes whatever you're doing it here, it will change the accelerometer values. Similarly, you can change the magnetic field. So say for example, if I change the magnetic field from to 100, so if you see there is some movement, and of course it will also depend on the other values probably. Yeah, so this is on along x, y and z axis. So if I keep both as 0, 0, and if I just move it to some value, so what I can see is there is not much changes from here, but there is a significant change if I change it over here. Yeah, so I'll just repeat that it's hard to emulate exactly the features in an emulator. But no, I'll do one thing. I'll build this file, build the APK file out of this app and run it on my actual phone and try to see what happens. So I'll pause this video. In the meantime, I'll transfer the APK file and install it on my real phone, and I'll be back soon. So I'm back. So I tried this on my real phone. It works perfectly fine. The pointer always points towards the note, whatever the movement of your phone be. So it works fine. I'll put the complete code and of course the screenshots from my phone, whatever I'm seeing, on my website programmerworld.co. I'll post the link on my in the description of this video. So I'll just quickly summarize this app development. It's very simple. You need a very simple layout. This reset button is to be honest redundant over here. You may choose not to put it. In the image, you can have a better image probably, which also shows north, south, east, west direction and all those things. So aesthetically, you can enhance this layout as much as per your requirement. Coming back to Java code, it's very simple. You need two sensors. One is the accelerometer and the magnetic field. Accelerometer is needed to know the gravity and the direction, and the magnetic field is needed to know the magnetic field available in the vicinity. So this is the real magnetic field and not some kind of mapping. So there are various ways of getting the magnetic field, by the way. I will not go in details in this video, but there are various ways. So this is the natural magnetic field which your phone experiences at any point of time or at any place on this planet Earth. And using this, you get the values of this sensors in the float gravity and float geomagnetic things. And then you use this get orientation method to get the orientation of your phone along the magnetic north pole. So this will also return other orientation like pitch and other values which you don't need. And at the end, you have to make sure that you convert this pi value to the degrees values, because the rotation of the image happens in degrees. So code is very simple, although it may look a bit lengthy because there is mostly copy paste. There are two sensors, that's why. And at the end, don't forget to register the sensors for the respective access to the respective sensors. This method is anyway, as I told, it's not needed. I just put it for as a backup. Yeah, that's all. So if you really want to enhance, the only enhancement which will require from the your side is to put some kind of better image with north, south, east, west direction and all those things. But otherwise, most of things looks good. So thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions or suggestions, then please put in the comment section. And if you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. Bye.